fit shit. I got shit on the nigga. Lil Baby will pop.
Hey everybody, my name is Unique Ransom. You know, may know me from Ransom Talk. And tonight I am so honored to be sitting next to Mr. Platinum Producer. Mister, I got almost all your songs in my playlist right now. Yeah, Mr. D-Mac, too banging. How you doing? I'm okay. What was your first reaction when you found out you went platinum?
Man, that was like, man, I remember the UFO told me I couldn't do this. You know what I mean? Folks used to laugh at me and shit, so it felt good.
When you went platinum, where was you at? Like, when did somebody call you?
Or? I think I was in the studio.
Oh, okay. Man, I bet that was a good feeling. What song went platinum?
Outside of the Young Boy.
And what was you thinking about when you made up the beat?
What was I thinking about?
Like, what? And did you think it'll be like this? This the joint right here.
I ain't think nothing. I just sunk it to him. And I was like, all right, this is style. I'm sending you joint to him. Something he'll be on, you know what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. So it turned out a blessing.
Right. Okay, well, how old were you when you really, like, started getting into beat making?
Like 14, 13.
And what made you do it?
What made me
like,
do
what
it?
Inspired like, you to start doing that?
One of my partners had showed me how to, work with the software and shit. Fruit Loop. So, took it from there. Shout out my nigga Ham. Mm-hmm.
Yeah, I seen it. Where you grew up?
I grew up in the Haven.
So, like, I seen that you went to college. You stayed in college for like a semester.
You did your research.
I did. Come on now.
I be doing these giant folks don't know nothing about me.
For real?
Yeah. You did your research.
Yeah, I'm supposed to.
So yeah, I did go to school. I dropped out though.
Yeah.
Got in some trouble.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? I got locked up. So I ain't had nothing but music. Mm-hmm. So after that, took out for me like God's plan.
Right. And I seen that you were saying like how your mom, she was like, look, I don't want you doing this.
She ain't want me doing this. Like, yeah. My mama, she a Christian woman. She don't play that. She ain't see nothing in it, but now she my biggest fan.
Yeah, that's right. But see, did that discourage you? Like you were saying,
it motivated me at the same time. I'm like weird or something. Because it like fueled me. It was like, I'm from prove y'all wrong, from show y'all what's up.
Mm-hmm.
I know I can do it, from show y'all what's up.
Mm-hmm.
That's how I was.
And did you ever think that you would go platinum? Like, did you ever think?
I ain't think that.
You ain't never.
Yeah, you're ruckus? No, I ain't think that.
Yeah.
I thought I'd be like, okay, all right, I'm cool. I ain't had nothing else going.
Right.
So he's had to work.
Right.
So this how I felt.
So, because you went to college, then you dropped out.
Football.
Right. You played football in college?
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah, when she blew it out.
Oh my God. Oh, I bet your mom was mad.
She was hot.
And so you went from making $25, $50 a beat. Then you just said
I still will give them away. Like, the industry be tricky, crazy. Like, you know what I'm saying? Like, producers a lot of times get paid on the back end.
Yeah.
A lot of back end. Man.
Right. So how did it make you feel now? Like, how much, what's the most, can I ask you what's the most you done made off of the beat?
Like, tomorrow I got like a $54,000 check coming tomorrow. We're supposed to hit anyway. So you can't like every few months.
Mm-hmm.
You know, love.
Okay. Name some of the artists you done worked with. Oh, already.
Man. Shit, got it. Bad, Young Boy. Lil Baby. Yellow Bees. A lot of niggas, man. A lot of niggas.
Yeah.
Going on and on.
So, do you think the music market is, like, oversaturated? You being a producer.
You can agree. Because everybody thinks, like, you should get rich quick.
Right. And they don't even know.
You got to put the work in. It's going to take some time. know what I'm saying? But if you stay in it, it'll work out.
But then sometimes I can see why people think that, because you do get the overnight ones.
Yeah.
Especially like the internet make it so easy to blow up overnight.
Right.
So, I mean, I can see that, but I can see like, you know, you get, if that's, if you really got a passion to do it, then you're going to put your work in.
Yeah.
So do you think Memphis right now is a hot market for upcoming?
Yeah, we've been had the juice. It's just we ain't know what to do with it.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? Like, God has stepped in and turned everybody up. Man, it's opportunity everywhere. You know what I'm saying? They watching the city. If you don't pop right now, you ain't never pop in Memphis. Oh, my God. That's how I feel. We like Atlanta right now.
Yeah, we really is, though. But if everybody sticks together, then it'll be even better.
It's getting better now. Keeping it together.
I definitely can agree with that. But, okay, so when you first started, you said you talked about Dolph not, like give you, like, nah, this shit
was
whack.
Nah, he didn't say it was whack. He was like, all right, so he was like, so I played the beef and I was like, damn, he was like, man, this joint hard, this joint ain't getting hard enough, bro. Like, these joints got to come through the speakers. And he don't know he gave me some free game right there, you know what I'm saying? So I felt that and I used it to my, you know what I'm saying, strength, and I turned up with it, you know what I'm saying? Like, right after he said that, that was a big part of my beef name. I'd be like, man, them joints, they hitting hard, everything, so. I'm gonna go back, fuck with Dolph, and we're gonna chop it up.
And then you know when you heard D-Mac 2 banging and then Take Heat. Man, I'm telling you, when you heard that, you be like, oh yeah, that jump in the bank.
We all came up together.
That's good. I'm so proud. Like, and then everybody like really trying to stick together. So, man, this is just, Memphis is a hot market right now. So, who you think, your honest opinion of next out of Memphis?
I like NLE Chopper. I like that young guy.
Mm-hmm.
I ain't gonna lie, I like him. He gonna be the next, cause his music like bigger than Memphis, you know what I'm saying? Yeah. Kevo Money too, his music bigger than Memphis. They music bigger than Memphis. They gonna be out of her.
Yeah,
you know what I'm saying? Give him like a year, they gonna be out of her. Not really hate doing that, cause there's a lot of other talent folk gonna be looking at me like,
no, this just your opinion. Opinion. Like, that's how you feel.
I like some other folks too.
Right,
too.
It's saying you don't like them.
Right, yeah.
Right, but you can kind of, can almost smell who's finna blow.
Yeah.
And Kevo Money, I've been saying it. Boy got soul. He got soul. Like, his music definitely make you be like, damn, how he come up with that? He's so young.
Exactly.
Yeah, you could tell he done. Yeah. Okay, anyways, let's get on some social media topics. So, you seen yesterday, Soulja Boy went viral.
Soulja Boy, he a legend. You gotta give it to him.
That's what I'm saying.
He had a point to prove, but like, at the same time, he was the first nigga doing this shit.
The very first one.
Internet shit. Everybody know, like.
The first one.
I was just telling my girl, like, I was just saying, like when he had the Gucci shoes and shit, I was like, damn, I want me some Gucci shoes. When I was young, he was that man. Like, you know what I'm saying? So, you gotta give it to him.
Got to give it to Soulja Boy. It's probably how he just coming out.
Yeah, he kind of jacked now, but he kind of bullshit now, but. He gonna get it together, hopefully.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? I fuck with him though.
Yeah, they been doing the Soulja Boy challenges and all that shit. But I feel like he was the first rapper to put it on YouTube.
Exactly.
Yeah.
He took it far.
He took it real far. Then with the game, like, everybody don't think he working because he ain't putting out the music, but he got the game system going. He's still doing his little thing.
He doing some stuff.
He just, you know, how he delivered his message.
Through music no more, so we don't really just crack.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? But he hard though. He still like, I like the little one. What's the joint? What's my
what?
His new song.
Cause I ain't even heard it.
I
heard
it. I had this to it. It's cool. It's cool, little.
Yeah. It's probably over with the music, with him, with it. Listen, Soulja Boy, I'm just saying.
He just followed me on social media too.
Oh, really?
Just followed me like about 2-3 days ago.
So I just know that feeling got to be like, and then you seem so humble. Like, you ain't even on that cocky shit. Like, you seem real humble. Like, they make a.
I'm laid back. I don't try to do too much.
Mm-hmm.
That's how I get my blessings. You know what I'm saying? I just wait my turn.
Right.
I don't force myself or nothing. Like, I just wait my turn. That's what worked for me. It might not work for other people. Somebody might gotta be aggressive. I ain't aggressive like that.
Right.
I'm like, babe, you just come to me.
Right.
That's how God got it set up. For real.
That's what's up. any advice you want to give up somebody that's trying to get into the music industry or?
Go hard, don't stop. No matter what. If you love this shit, you can get paid off this shit. Trust me. If you love it, you can get paid. And just go hard.
Okay. Well, what can the people expect from you this year?
Man, just everything on a whole nother level. More records. Man, more jewelry. You know what I'm saying? Not the fake shit either. The real shit, some real diamonds.
Real jewelry.
Yeah, not the cap shit. And just working. I'm going to sign somebody too this year. I'm going to sign somebody.
So you got your own life.
Sign me an artist, yeah. Forever banger.
Yeah, I heard it. Yeah. So he looking for some dope music.
Yeah, I'm on the
What about some singles?
That's cool. If you wanna
y'all be so hard on me.
I ain't really no R&B guy like that. I'm gonna break into that on down the line. I gotta get this million off the rock first.
Okay.
Then I'm gonna break into that when I get older. It's the older me. I like R&B music though. I'm mature like that. You know what I'm saying?
What some of the R&B artists did you listen to?
I listen to Her. I listen to Yellow. I like a little LMA.
Okay.
What's the new girl? Queen.
Queen Naja.
Naja. Yeah. She's cold.
Oh, shit. Okay.
That's the new place on R&B.
Right. Definitely. Yeah. Definitely. So, but in the men's category, because you know the little king of R&B going on right now. So who do you think the king of R&B? Because you still got an ear for music. So
yeah,
who you think the king?
Jacquees, he's killing me right now. Jacquees, he live right now. Trey Songz.
Jacquees?
What's the other little dude?
Chris Y'all Brown. Mean, what
Chris
about
Brown?
Chris Brown?
He cool. He come, yeah.
Singing wise.
Yeah, he cool.
Chris Brown.
I don't listen to Chris Brown like this, so I don't, you know. He might be the better judge than that. You know what I'm saying? He cool.
Okay. Any shout outs you want to give somebody while we wrap this up?
Shout out to the city of Memphis, man. You know what I'm saying? It's our time. Let's turn up. Let's stay together. Let's stay non-violent. You know what I'm saying? Let's get this money.
That's right.
That's it.
All right. And my name is Unique. Once again, I'm out.
Yeah. With the drugs on me. I just went bonkers all up exclusive game. Flat fuck like a dove on me. Damage wet like a tub on me.